I know we're here talking about the World Cup, but a lot of changes in Munster, the two new coaches. I'd imagine you'll have an interest yourself in Larkham and Rowntree. I'd imagine probably Larkham might have been a bit of a hero and you would have worked with Rowntree as well, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I worked with Graham for the Lions, and a great fella. You know, a bit of a motivator, I suppose. He's a scrum coach, so he doesn't have much to do with me. Maybe we'll go through the feeds of a scrum, but other than that, my experience with him was just, you know, a real tough guy that you respect and you want to play for. So that'll be a boost to Munster, and obviously Larkham, like you said, a bit of a hero growing up, and highly regarded in Australia in world rugby. So, you know, that's going to be really exciting for Munster when we come back to get to work with them.
I imagine, though, the hero probably goes to the wayside when they start yelling at you.
Probably, yeah. Try and get off on the front foot with him and make sure, you know, he's a guy, like I said, a bit of a hero and a guy you respected. So, you know, when you get back and you're face-to-face with him, you want to impress him and, you know, I suppose learn off him, sponge as much information as you can. And, you know, hopefully he makes a big difference to Munster going forward. You know, like I said, towards the end of last year, you know, we were quite close. We're just looking for that little bit extra. So hopefully those two guys can bring something.
The same could be said of the Irish setup as well, I suppose, this year. You know, things just, to put it kindly, didn't go to plan. So how are you able to recalibrate, to kind of put the dirty diesel out of the system, so to speak, and start motoring again?
I think we're a really honest group, and we learn from our mistakes pretty quickly. And, you know, I suppose if you look over the last couple of seasons, you know, this group has been really successful, and you know, we'll realise what didn't work in the previous Six Nations. But, you know, I think we've ironed those creases out already. You know, we, after each game that didn't go to plan, we kind of recognised that, we reviewed it and sorted it out. And, you know, this group has an awful lot more positive performances to draw on than the few bad ones in the Six Nations just gone. So overall, it's been really positive, and you know, there's a fresh feeling amongst the group coming back here and getting down to work. And, you know, I think everyone from players, coaching staff, outside staff is aware of what this group is capable of, and I don't think we're going to be kind of painted or reviewed based on that Six Nations solely. You know, I think this group has been through an awful lot together, has, you know, Six Nations titles and massive wins against Southern Hemisphere oppositions to kind of rely on. So, you know, we know it's there. It's just about getting the best out of ourselves. Really, you know, you have four games and you want to get up to speed with your near enough your strongest team come the end of those four games and be able to fly out to Japan knowing that, you know, combinations and there's a bit of rhythm to what's going on within the squad. My motivation is, you know, it's a world stage. You want to be on the plane. You want to be able to be in the best condition you can be in and put in the performances you and the team are capable of on a world stage. And you know, each one has been different. You know, the first one was relatively new, 2015. We fairly high hopes, and it was a bit of a disappointment. And, you know, since then, I think this team has been through a lot more ups than it has downs. So, you know, that's why the freshness and the buzz is here for the last 3 weeks. And people are really enjoying getting down to work because, you know, like I said, we know what the squad is capable of, and hopefully we can, you know, the squad can get ready to travel out there in a rich vein of form. From my experience being away that long, you know, you need a kind of a happy squad, a squad that can, you know, switch on when it's rugby time and be able to switch off and enjoy each other's company when you get the downtime, because there can be a lot of it when you're away on tour, especially a foreign country like Japan. I had a under 20s World Cup there, and it's a lot different to anywhere else I've toured. So yeah, it's going to be pretty special, please God.
And what are your main memories from that under 20 World Cup?
Really warm, really warm and humid. Yeah. And that is going to be a bit of a factor out there. You know, getting used to that, especially playing at such a high intensity at World Cup level, it goes up again, and just being aware of that. So we've you know, integrated things like that into our training in terms of, you know, sweat vests and things like that, and mimicking the heat, which is quite hard to. But you know, I think we're due to go to Portugal later on in pre-season too, which will give us another taste of the heat. But it's pretty warm here at the moment, so you know, we're getting used to it. It's great, crack. It's unbelievable place to be, and I'm not just saying that. I think this group is, you know, has been around together for a while now. You know, there's you've great mates here. You've lads you get on really well with. The slagging is always good, and Yeah, I think we have a fine balance of it. I think, you know, last night we had a players quiz in the evening and that went down really well. It was quite a bit of fun, and you know, lads can switch off, go for like anything. I think, you know, lads are always up to something. There's always a group to go away and do something with. And
is your time micromanaged, or do you have a lot of time where you can choose your own activities, or a bit more freedom within the camp?
It's a bit of both, really. I think it's a great balance. You know, some lads on the down days like to play a bit of golf, some lads like to go for a swim and chill out, and you know, that freedom is there. And I think the coaches and management are really good at that, giving us our own time. And you know, I think lads are well used to touring and being away from home. And you know, I think it's quite a laid back atmosphere when we're away from the pitch, and it kind of, there's a natural kind of friendship around the lads. You know, it's a very easy place to be.
You might feel, I was just thinking, when you keep talking about your motivation, your teammates, and it's obvious there is a bond, I'd say, do you guys feel a bit protective about each other too at times? You know, and I know we're here, the media, sometimes we can throw things that may be accurate, maybe less accurate at times, you know, and it must be hard to take at times. It just, and when I hear you say, because it's obvious there is a deep friendship there.
Yeah, personally, I don't see an awful lot of media. I've learned that over the years. I don't think it can be, you know, if you play well, it can probably blow you up a little bit too much. And if it doesn't go to plan, maybe it's a little bit exaggerated. And that's just the nature of what it is. So, you know, I think within our team, we're realistic about where we're at. And we know, you know, how hard people try and how good people can be. And I suppose, you know, when things don't go right for fellas or the team as a group, we kind of rally around each other. And, you know, we've been through tough times before, we've bounced back. And it's a really tight group. I think, I don't know if you say, like, you probably see it from the outside how tight fellas are and how well fellas get on together, just from the energy around the squad or when you see us out and about. I think, you know, it's a really tight-knit group. And that's, I think, going to be massive for a stint that could last until November. So it's really important, and I think it's there. It's definitely there, and it's a really competitive group too. We drive each other on to get better. So, like I said, a really, really enjoyable camp to be involved in.